Dear Esther, this is a game that is filled with both beauty and perfection. A perfection in the arts. The first thing about this game is what grabs the player's attention is both the narrative and the sightseeing, with the add-on of perfect music to fit both the emotion and the tone of the story being told. The player is felt as though he is alone. Alone in a cold island with nothing but emotion.
So how do I play this game?
What do you mean how to play this game?
Well, so far I know how to move. But apparently my spacebar won't work. I won't be able to crouch. Apparently my flashlight turns on automatically in dark places.
I think you should just walk around the map.
Well, I don't know. Maybe I should just look at the controls, maybe that'll help me.
I would not just walk around for a bit, that's all I need you to do.
What?
What's wrong?
There is no what? There is no jump. No crouch. No. What type of a game are you letting me play that has no controls, no nothing?
It's just a game that I'm just gonna have to.
It doesn't even have a flashlight option.
Are you really complaining
about
this?
To turn it on and off. It's automatic. That's disgusting. No. You know what? You play this game.
What?
I am not.
Look, you've only played the game for like less than, let's say, 5 minutes.
Exactly. Nothing happened during that time, so it's
dead,
completely boring to
I
me.
Do not
and therefore, I don't really want to play
Chickenous.
It.
Okay, all I need you to do is just walk around and experience it. I'm not asking much from you.
You are actually asking a lot.
Well,
to play your fancy, artsy-fartsy game, which I do not want to play.
It's not fancy, it's just a game that I just need you to play for me, please.
You won't leave me alone about this, will you?
Okay, really, how much can it hurt? I'm the one who paid for it.
Okay, fine, I'll play your art game.
The game is built between both seeing and hearing. The narration is building up its temptation in the story for the player to find out whether you are guilty or saddened or ashamed by what has happened. It is left to the player to decide if he must move on or he must stop between the...
There is a big hole here.
Well, go around it.
Aw, damn it.
What happened?
Well, I kind of... Never mind, I found my way around it.
Now please, stop interrupting. It begins to build up as a mountain. A stretch between you and what you achieve. Your goals and your dreams. All crushed. And as you begin to set...
I found something. Seems to be scissors, blood, and a lot of needles.
Yes, I know. I've played this game before. Now please, stop interrupting.
Sorry.
A stretch between reality and fantasies. As though an ocean wave begins to smother itself on the beach. The feeling of loneliness is struck as though a hand... is being taken.
I found some baby scanner photos, a book, and some eggs.
What did I just tell you?
Right, sorry.
Affection of privacy and equivalence. As the game begins to show and teach, as though whether you are to forgive, to look away, to not mention, or to do something about what has happened in the past. Or though some things cannot be taken away, and some things can,
what are you doing?
Well,
while I'm looking around, what does it look like I'm doing?
Okay, right now, I don't really need you to look around. I need you to stay on track right now.
Okay, did you want me to just walk around, or did you want me to actually play it and experience it?
Right now, I just need you to walk around. Please?
But fine. Fine. You know what? Fine. The beauty that is shown in this amazing game is beyond anyone's recognition. Although it may not be, but when you do play it, you will find the light of this game's heart and descend down.
Damn it, just fall down the hole already!
Okay, listen, I've had just about enough of your shitty poetry and what the heck you're talking about through this whole review, because you have not mentioned anything that anybody would even listen to. So, let me help you with that.
What do you do? Stop!
Hello? He left. Yep.